Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study about chemical equations. So last day we studied how to write the molecular formula of a compound, and now in chemistry we are dealing with chemical reactions, isn't it? So from 7th standard onwards we are studying about how to write a chemical equation. Last year we studied how to balance a chemical equation also, okay? So I think you all know how to balance a chemical equation. And one more thing, I'm not getting any response, not only Joel send me notes, not even one boy except Joel is submitting the notes. You see this year 10th standard, how much responsible they are. They are attending the class regularly and always submitting the notes, and they are very eager to do the test papers and all. But this 9th standard, what happened to you? Your boys, especially boys, boys are not at all responding. So that is chemical equation we are going to study. Chemical equation is actually the shorthand representation of a chemical reaction. So chemical equation, underline that, chemical equation is a shorthand form for a chemical change. Chemical equation shows the result of a chemical change in which the reactants and the products are represented by symbols and formulas. So that is also very important. We have to use symbols for the representation of a chemical reaction in chemical equation. So it is very important. Before that you have to study all the symbols of elements, and after that you write, you should know how to write the compound molecular formulae. So after that only you can write the chemical equation and balance that, okay? So chemical equation ennu parney kanyal chemistry il nammal eppozhum, I told you that symbols are very important in chemistry, isn't it? So for a chemical reaction to represent, we have to use chemical equation. Understood? So that is our next topic, chemical equation. So for writing a chemical equation, some rules are there. Always we use reactants. What are reactants? Reactants are the chemical substances that are participating in a chemical reaction. So these reactants, their symbols are always writing on the left side. Okay, you see, left hand side, ammonium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. So two reactants are there, so we have to put a plus sign for that. And these two react together, we will get product, and that product we should write always on the right hand side, and we should represent the formation by an arrow mark, isn't it? So how we are writing, that is ammonium hydroxide NH4OH plus HCl. So these are two reactants. From this it is understood that these two are joining, and we are getting a product, and that is NH4Cl, and one more product we are getting, that is water. Understood? So like this we are writing a chemical equation. Some examples are given. Okay, one reactant and two, three products. Okay, two lead nitrate gives two PbO plus. Appo etra reactants varuno appo plus ittu kodukanam product adu pole. For number of products we have to put plus sign. Okay, so different examples are given there. Two reactants and one product. Okay, ammonia NH3. So two reactants undalle, but we got only one product. Mg plus 2HCl gives MgCl2 plus H2. Two reactants and three or four products. Okay, a very lengthy equation. But there are some limitations for these writing this chemical equation in this way. Okay, what are the information that we are getting, and what are the limitations of writing chemical equation in this way? So that is the next one. A chemical equation tells us about what are the things we can get. We will get about the reaction from the chemical equation. Okay, the chemical nature of reactants and products, the nature of elements and radicals involved, and direction also, from which direction it is taking place. irreversible ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഒറ്റ ഒരു ആരോ അല്ലേ കഴിഞ്ഞ വർഷം പഠിച്ചതല്ലായിരുന്നോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നോക്കിക്കേ സോ ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് ഒറ്റ ഒരു ആരോ മാർക്കേ ഉള്ളൂ അല്ലേ ബട്ട് സം റിയാക്ഷൻസ് ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ NaCl so this is a double arrow that means this reaction may occur, will occur reverse also thirichum nadakkuvanna idinte artham ketto so this is irreversible reaction this is reversible reaction so by the chemical equation we can understand whether it is in which direction that reaction is taking place understood